Last week, I got a chance to check out the premiere of Baggage Claim, all right, with David E. Talbert up in White Marsh. Now we're in my movie theater. Okay, and now we're gonna do a little review on the movie. So let's see what they talk about with this movie. Are you ready for this? You ready? I said, are you ready? Yeah, yeah.
You spent your whole life being your own woman. Why you wanna change now?
I just would really like to be somebody else's too.
Now is not the time to get down on yourself, Montana. In a week, maybe.
When you find love, and you will, don't ever let it go.
Honey, what are you doing?
He just wanted international travel booty.
That man could have had intergalactic travel booty.
Nobody move! I have no life, which gives me all day to ruin yours.
Come on, bro.
Great movie, humorous, very funny, but at the same time, twisted in real life events that really happened and almost had you self-reflecting on situations that has happened in your life. So with that whole movie, it's all about a woman that needs to find love, is approaching the age where I know that women start to panic a little bit around that 30 range or mid 30s. And she's trying to find a date for one of the weddings that, her sister's wedding, matter of fact. She's under still, tremendous pressure with that. And so she feels like she has to go out and find a boyfriend. So she goes back and she has her friends help her with finding different exes that she used to talk to.
I can't go to my little sister's wedding single.
If you need a man, honey, I can get you one of those.
It's not a man I need, it's a husband or a potential husband in a month.
Why don't you marry Gail? If she goes a week without waxing her mustache, they'll think it's Steve Harvey.
Look, it's not like she's got enough time to meet somebody new, so why not revisit somebody else?
For the next few weeks, any of your exes that flies anywhere at any time, we're gonna know.
That's right.
It kind of seems like a lot of women, for some reason, think that it's a failure if they're not married or don't have kids by a certain age or time period, when that doesn't really matter if your surroundings don't fit, what they're seeking. So I think that in certain situations, it's okay, even though the outside says, oh man, you're not to a level or a status that you're supposed to be on right now, but they don't understand the small little intricate things that go on in your life, that makes your surroundings the way it is and makes things the way they are. So if you're not ready for something, you're just not ready for it. Because sometimes people go into things too prematurely to me. This is all my opinion. People go into things too prematurely and they end up being in a situation that is actually detrimental to their environment and to their life and to their world.
Wow, you're doing well for yourself.
Damon?
Who is that?
This ain't my house. It's hers. I can't afford this.
Damon Diesel's situation, okay, he's basically faking the funk and acting like he's at a status that he's not at. He's pretending. He's faking. And I think that is a very true situation coming from club scenes and a lot of guys that go to the club. A lot of guys fake out there, man. So have I ever been in a situation like that? Nah, I've never been in a situation like that. Maybe, of course, you can stretch the truth in certain situations, but you can't just flat out just lie like that in somebody else's house. I mean, come on.
Behind every great man, there is an even greater woman. Sometimes being greater means being quiet.
Langston, played by Taye Diggs, which is a controlling ex in her life, going to politics and has almost like a structure that he needs somebody to just fit in and almost just have an arm piece.
This is Montana.
Can I pet her?
I'm sorry. She's jealous.
Oh, he has a dog. A dog that obeys every single thing he says. And basically, that represents what he wants his mate to inherit, basically, in his whole realm, his whole political realm. and what he wants his wife or, you know, him, like his mate to be.
Montana Moore.
Eamon Diesel.
Montana.
Brandon.
Montana.
Langston.
Montana.
Curtis.
Demon Hansu. Play Quinn in the movie. Rich than a bitch.
Passion adventure is what you want. Join me.
The thing is, man, at least he made it clear off the jump, man. And like, I respect him for that, to make it clear off the jump exactly what he wants, instead of trying to just lead this woman in the, you know, down a false hope or false path, you know.
What are you doing?
He just wanted international travel booty.
That man could have had intergalactic travel booty.
The, you know, character that Boris Kodjo plays.
Did he pop the question?
Boris Kodjo lying to that girl like that, man. Come on, man, lying to that girl like that. I mean, you just, you just gotta lose out. You just gotta lose out, man, you know? You know, just tell the girl the truth. Tell the girl the truth and let her decide, man. But she still wants to do it that, hey, you know, do what you gotta do. But at least, you know, at least let them decide for themselves. Come on, Boris. MSU. I went to Morgan, MSU. So definitely, man, that experience, black college experience, historically black college experience is something that I wouldn't give back for anything. That experience is something that you, like, nobody would know unless you actually went to HBCU. It's just different and it's one of a kind, man. So, to really dig your way out of a hole, as some people say, by starting off at a historically black college, I don't truly think that that's the case. Because I think that if it's something for you, it's gonna happen. If the plan is for you, it's definitely gonna happen no matter what school you go to. And that's a connection to me. And I'll definitely show support for a fellow alum. MSU alum especially, you know, that just that black college, you know.
So, I think it's Steve Harvey.
Yeah, man, it's all love, man.